I'm attorney Pat Dunn. Auto accidents are a part of life. I hope you never need an attorney, but if you do, the team at the Mack Law Firm is here to help.
We're back at Hammond Square, just about everybody's favorite place around here to go, with Grady Brame. And as usual, Grady, you have lots of good news to share from this tremendous retail center.
Yeah, Hammond Square has had an excellent year. A number of our tenants are up 40 or 50% in 2021 over 2020. We have several tenants whose sales are up almost 100% over 2020. Number of them are having record years, the highest sales they've ever had. I think there's a lot of pent-up demand. People want to get out and shop, and that's reflective of the traffic that we have here. It's reflective of the sales that we've gotten this year, and so we're real excited.
Matter of fact, you know, you've added quite a few stores here and places to eat just in recent months.
Correct. I mean, we added Michael's and Home Goods and Walk-On's, Enterprise Rental Car, all this year. You know, late last year we added PetSmart, Five Below, and Michael's. So it's been great, and all of those stores are doing excellent.
Now, if a year ago we had done this interview, I would have asked you if the pandemic and the proliferation of online shopping would have killed retail. Now we can answer that question and say definitely not.
I definitely think that's the case. I mean, you know, people do online shopping, but many people are doing online shopping and they come to physically pick it up at Best Buy or Home Goods or Home Depot or whatever. But we believe that the shopping center is here to stay. People want to get out. They want to come shop. They want to physically touch some merchandise that they're buying. So we're really excited about it, and I think the sales here at Hammond Square reflect that pent-up demand.
Are you 100% back from Hurricane Ida?
Yes, we are. I mean, we were fortunate. We had some pylon damage and some landscape damage, minor roof repairs, but everything is taken care of with the exception of the pylon. The sign contractors are so busy because so many signs were down and it's hard to get materials, and that's the only thing that's lagged. But we were shut down for about 2 or 3 days due to lack of power. But other than that, we're 100% back.
Matter of fact, I think you're probably building back better, to coin a phrase.
I think we are. And you know, some of those events add to the demand for shoppers wanting to get out. So it's been a really good year.
What do you foresee coming here in months to come?
You know, we don't have much expansion land left. We do have some shops along Main Street. You know, we're pushing services, insurance, financial planners, medical. You know, we think that's kind of the future of the small shops along Main Street. But I mean, outside of that, I mean, we think we're going to see just more of the same. It's a good tenant mix. You know, we've been able to fill in, you know, the loss of Sears with some great retailers. And, you know, it's more of a mature shopping center, if you will, rather than a growing one right now.
Well, to a lot of us, Five Guys and Chipotle, they were no-brainers. But what about restaurants that you might get here in the future?
Well, you know, we added Walk-On's, Little Saigon, Five Guys, and Chipotle all last year. We added Margaritas in the last couple of years. We're always in the market for another restaurant or two, but we've got a good mix that covers, you know, a lot of the restaurant uses.
I came across a statistic the other day that really surprised me. We're in a big state, all the way from New Orleans to Shreveport. Is this really the second largest open-air shopping center in Louisiana?
Yes, it is. It's Hammond, Louisiana is home of the second largest shopping center in Louisiana. And, you know, we've got over 900,000 square feet here. I mean, it's just a remarkable, tribute to the local economy that we can have such a dynamic property here in Hammond.
Any idea how many people work here? Is it about 1,000, just to guess?
off the top of my head, I don't know. We had done some statistics several years back, and I don't have it, but I would suspect it's well over 1,000.
You know, a lot of folks from out of town who have not been here, whenever I travel and speak with them, they ask me about Hammond Square because, as they say, they see it from I-12, and it looks very impressive, very attractive from the interstate. So it's almost like the best advertising Hammond, Louisiana could ever get.
No doubt about it. The frontage that we have along I-12 is very beneficial for the property. I mean, it shows well. You know, the new additions with the roundabouts really have helped traffic. I know some people have trouble with roundabouts, but we think it's been a great addition. People can get in and out of here very easily, and so you know, it's well located, and you know, one of the reasons why it's really doing well.
You know, to bring up what was a sore subject many years ago, let's not forget the access off C.M. Fagan. I mean, you really have four corners here that all have very good ingress and egress.
No doubt about it. When we built the shopping center, about 30% of our customers were coming from the west, down Fagan Drive. So, you know, we've got access from north, south, you know, east and west. And, you know, and it's reflective of people being able to get in here and get in and out of here.
Can you break down where your shoppers come from? You know, one component that always surprises people is to discover how far from the north, well into Mississippi, you attract people.
No doubt. I mean, we attract all the way up to Macomb, and even we've gotten a handful from Brookhaven. So we go all the way down to LaPlace. We don't go that far to the east to Covington, but we will go all the way over to Livingston and Walker, where people are coming back over here to shop. So that's really our primary geographic area that we're drawing from.
On the other hand, you know, families who have students at Southeastern and so forth, maybe they live in Covington, but it's placing them in Hammond a good bit.
Yeah, it does. I mean, we get a handful over there, but, you know, Covington has a lot of the same tenants that we do. So, but we serve a pretty big geographic area, and, you know, I think the geographic area has about 140, 45,000 people that we are attracting from.
How many corporations are represented here?
That I don't know off the top of my head.
But it just occurs to me that from the standpoint of corporate America, the success of Hammond Square in Little Hammond, Louisiana, it must be a tremendous economic development boost to have all of these corporate giants here.
I think there's no question about it. I mean, you know, Best Buy, Target, Ulta, TJ Maxx, Home Goods. I mean, they're not going to come to an area where they can't be successful. And one of the reasons we attracted Home Goods was because TJ Maxx was doing so good. And you know, they're both owned by TJX, which is a, you know, multinational corporation. And you know, it's a testament to the market that we can have a lineup like this.
Well, tell us something about Hammond Square that people don't know and might be surprised to hear.
You know, you said it earlier. It's the second largest open air shopping center in the state of Louisiana. That's something very few people would realize. When you look at the tenant mix here, with the size of Hammond, Louisiana, I mean, it's remarkable to have Home Depot, Academy, TJX, the TJX concepts, Target, Ulta, Books a Million, Old Navy. I mean, it's really a exceptional shopping center, and has done very well.
What else do you want to share with us?
You know, we're excited about the future. I think we're going to continue to try to market the property to help tenants increase sales. You know, we hope to fill in Main Street with some of the services that I mentioned before.
You know, to have had a guy like Jimmy Moran and the other local leaders who got together years ago to make Hammond Square a reality, we're really blessed.
There's no doubt about it. A lot of folks don't understand the risk that was taken when we developed this, and the risk taken by Jimmy and his brother Bobby and his cousin Calvin Fayard. And, you know, the result speaks for itself. But there were a lot of very difficult times when we were developing this thing, and but we made it through it, and I think it's, I think it's a great property.
Had they not done that, had you all not done that, this would today be one of the many abandoned malls falling into ruin across the nation.
No doubt about it. This property would have been an abandoned mall, and now it's not.
It takes more than one person to assist in a personal injury claim. I am attorney Glenn Westmoreland, and we have a strong team at the Mack Law Firm. It is our goal to make sure your injury is properly attended to. Contact me at tangylawteam.com and let us get you the help you need.